So a friend of mine was on the server and just told me to go check out the server. So I came on, he wanted to show me something. And when I logged in, I was like, wait, where did I log off? And I looked around. Oh, wait, I logged off at my base, but where's my base? Someone griefed my base. Someone griefed me on my own server. Wow. Low blow. I know who did it. And it's really easy to undo. And actually, I don't really mind so much showing off who they are. I'm just worried that it might encourage people in the future to grief. But it's been a while since I've recorded anything on the public server. So I guess it's not... oh, yeah, that's who did it, by the way. I guess this is the start of me doing stuff on the server again. But I guess this is a way to show you guys how powerful, like, some of the tools are when you're running a Minecraft server. So, obviously, this guy, like, just completely demolished my base. Actually, all of these mobs were dead. But when I undid everything, they all spawned back in. I want to kill them all, but they're a little... Let's see, can I /PT smite? Can't out them. Let me kill these guys. When I undid everything, these guys came back to life, which means he killed all of them, which is kind of obnoxious, but that's fine. Let me just kill all of these guys before they get out into the world. Ow, got myself. But yeah, wow. I don't even know if, CO inspect, if my base is still here? Or if, wow, he did a thorough job of, like, undoing everything that I've done. I am both impressed and kind of annoyed at the same time, but mainly I am impressed. Impressed. Okay, let's roll myself back. CO roll back. User dad. Oh, you did. Oh, no, I'm silent mist. Can I? No, silent mist time. 1 minute radius 20. Let me just undo what I just did. And so here's what I mean by some of the tools that I have being ridiculously powerful. So you see this entire area? It's completely, like, screwed up. I did the thing, about to do it now. So if I just execute this command, I will roll back everything this person has done. Actually, let me increase this. I don't know if this person's been on the server, but basically, if you grief, I undo everything that you do, and then, yeah. Look, all my stuff is back. I might need to spawn in the cows again. Oh, no, I don't. They are perfectly fine, but yeah. Everything is back to normal except for my horse is dying. No, no, get out of the wall, you. Oh, and Ban Rose Jack. Was it Jack? Yeah. Griefing. Greeting now. Griefing. Squinty face. So, yeah, it's very easy to undo everything. Literally takes one command. So, I mean, if you want to grief me to you know, like, to get sponsored on a video, I'm probably not gonna do this again, but it's funny, like, people have threatened to grief me on the server and I'm like, okay. And it's just so easy to undo, so there's little to no point in doing it. Also, I'm not even on my normal account, I'm on a completely different account, but that user is no longer a member of the server, so yeah, I guess now I should cut into when I actually do stuff on the server as opposed to admin stuff, because there really isn't too much more to admin around. Let's see, TP Twix. Are the chests gone? I have a feeling that all the stuff that he took or put in places were my chests, and then he moved all the stuff here. He said he was surrounded in chests. I kind of wish that I got to see what that looked like, but alas, here's Twix's house. I know him. He's a friend. That's Max. If you watch the vlog, first of all, if you don't watch the vlog, you should go subscribe to my vlog channel. Second of all, Max has been in the vlogs multiple times, and just recently he decided to come play on the server. So much fun. Okay, I'm gonna hop onto the not admin account and mess around a little bit on the server. Be right back. almost a day later, I'm back and on my normal account. I was actually going to start recording a little bit earlier, but then I had a bit of an issue with the server. I must have set my group to something strange because I needed to make this account an admin temporarily. And after I did that, well, everything got messed up. I couldn't do anything. I couldn't talk. I couldn't eat. I couldn't open this door. I thought the server had crashed, but then I restarted the server and the server and nothing changed. And I was like, wow, this is a problem. So I reverted my rank back. I should be a potato crafter now, which is good. That's exactly what I wanted to do. But yeah, we are back on the Potato Craft Vanilla server. And let me tell you guys, it has been a really long time since I have last played on the server. And by that, I mean, actually, that's kind of a lie. I've been sort of doing things here and there, but it's been a long time since I have recorded on the server, obviously. I don't think a video on the server has gone out in quite some time, maybe about a month or so. Maybe not that long, but pretty darn close to that. And yeah, I want to change that because I've been getting into the swing of recording again, and it's been quite a bit of fun. Well, here we are just slaughtering tons and tons of animals while I explain this to you. But as of the last few days, I've been pretty good about not missing any days with uploads, and I want to keep that going, and I want to expand that to doing more than one thing a day, because right now it's just been one video a day. So hopefully as time continues or time increases, as T approaches infinity, the number of videos also approaches infinity or approaches infinity times two, which you can't do that. That's not how math works. You can't multiply infinities, but can you? Can't you? Could you? Wouldn't it be cool if you could? Let's do slash home. But other than that, I've been playing so much TerraFirmaCraft over the last few days that I haven't had... Well, I shouldn't say that I haven't had time to play Minecraft, but I've been playing TerraFirmaCraft instead of on this server because TFC is a lot of fun. Let me tell you guys, if you haven't sent an application to join the server, I do suggest that you do because the server is... Well, it's been a lot of fun so far, and I can only see it getting better. But let's see. Let's do all of that. Need to free up some inventory space because I have no space. But I think since the last episode, I've gotten quite a few enchanted tools. Yeah, I've been on the hunt for experience and food and resources and just a bunch of stuff as of late. I haven't been doing too much in terms of building, but I think last time I recorded on here, my intention for the next episode was to start to build a house because we've been living inside of like a little hole for quite some time. And well, I want to start to live in a nice house because building houses is fun, even though 90% of my houses just turn into rectangles. Is that so bad though? I like my rectangular houses. They have that potato-y character that, well, that anyone could have if they just built a rectangular house. But, okay, like, I wanted to kill these cows because they were really hurting my frame rate. Every time you looked in this general area, the frame rate would go down, but I think we've killed enough of them to sort of regain a frame rate. But that doesn't matter. We need to kill the rest of them. But I'm going to cut in just a sec because, yeah, I want to really thin out this population. But other than that, yeah, the first part of this, we rolled back some damage caused by a player, and that person is an interesting person to say the very least. I've been talking to them on Discord, and wow, they are a fascinating person right there. But all that has been resolved, and well, as you can obviously see, my stuff is all back, so no damage done, and it's always nice. I really like the tools that we have to make sure that permanent damage doesn't happen. Like, it's really hard to inflict permanent damage on a server nowadays, just because the admin tools are so powerful. And wow, my inventory is getting really full with just dead cow everywhere. And I'm starving. Imagine that. Oh, the irony. I'm starving as I slaughter this food. So tasty. Okay, let's actually eat. But yeah, I guess I will make a quick cut to when I am done with the crowd thinning tactics that I'm currently doing, and then we will build a house. Okay, now that my inventory is full of nothing but steak and dead cow, the crowd has been thinned quite a bunch. Quite a bunch. But yeah, I also didn't mention that we have giant farms just everywhere right now, and that's because I've been gathering all the resources for animal breeding, and experience making. Actually, like, most of it's for, these farms are mainly made for potatoes, so I could grow a lot of potatoes and then cook them. But then I figured if I just make wheat, I can make a bunch of cows and then, you know, exterminate them. Wow, extermination is a very strong word. But yeah, I've been using these fields as just a way of getting lots of resources really fast, getting lots of experience really fast, because I've needed a lot of tools. And it's actually really funny. I've been trying to start back my series on the Minecraft Life, that world, and the single player world, and everything was going great, and then I accidentally died in lava and lost everything that I had gotten ready for the episode that was going to be me returning and doing all the nice stuff again. So that was super unfortunate, but I guess worse things have happened, although I don't know when I'm going to begin that series again, because I spent a couple of days just getting stuff ready, and then I lost most of just about everything except for the resources that I had gained, and I was really going for, I was enchanting a bunch of stuff, so losing all of the enchanted tools is quite the loss. And where did all of that dirt go? Over here. But yeah, it's house building time. So I'm going to build my house over a chunk of this farmland. This farmland over here was just added so I'd have space to grow more vegetables. Is wheat a vegetable? I don't think so. Vegetables and grains are separate, right? Something like that. And right now I need to plug up all of these water things to hopefully make all of this land turn back into dry and desolate land, because yeah, that is the most optimal thing, which means that I probably don't need to actually tear it out. I just need to have all the water go away so it dries up, and oh no, I'm out of dirt. Man, this is going swimmingly. Okay, so what we're going to do is make a very basic outline of what the house is going to look like, and then we'll just build up some walls from there. I'm going to go for something a little bit more different than what I normally do. Usually we have like these pretty plain everythings that just aren't that exciting, but today, no. Today we are going to go for a crazy shaped house, and then I guess I'll just fill in the details as we go. Sound like a plan? I sure hope so. So let's see. This is going to be part of it. Oh crap, I probably need some stone bricks. As a matter of fact, I don't think I'm gonna need some stone bricks. I know I'm gonna need them. Since the last episode, though, I made this little furnace room over here, which is home to all of our furnaces, obviously, and I moved them out of here, so this area up here looks quite a bit cleaner. And do I really not have any stone bricks? Wow, okay, I have a bunch of stones, so that works. I was gonna say, I am sad that I don't have stone bricks. Let's do this. Oh wow, I am super out of it. I've been trying to reset my sleep schedule as of late, so my sleep schedule has been really wonky, and as a result, I've been, like, constantly really tired, and at the very least, I think it's finally fixed. I woke up today at 5 a.m., as opposed to the much later times. I've been going to bed around 5 a.m., actually, so waking up at 5 a.m. is definitely an improvement, but nonetheless, it is still a little annoying that I've been really tired all the time, because I've been working really hard to fix my sleep schedule. And now that I'm finally doing that, it's nice. It's nice being able to wake up and not be super exhausted, or rather not going to. The problem has mainly been in the fact that I've been going to bed at, like, oh my god, I can't build, at somewhere in the realm of 6 a.m. every day, and then waking up really, really late. Go to bed at like 6 and then wake up at 2, and it just gets worse from there, and oh, it's not good. It's super not good. And I am just happy that it is finally on the hopefully fixed end of the fixing part of the procedure. And yeah, in the future, hopefully I won't break it. Wow, it has been really bad. But yeah, as a result, the last couple of days have been really difficult. Yesterday I pretty much slept the entire day, but that was because the day before I had gotten about 3 hours of sleep, and then the day before that I had gotten somewhere similar, because I went to bed around, actually no, I shouldn't say I got 3 hours of sleep, I was getting 3 hour blocks of sleep. Like, I would go to bed at 6 p.m. and then wake up at 9, and then I'd go to bed at 12 and wake up at 3, and it would just continue and continue, and it was just it was really bad for the last couple of days, because I've just been in a constant constant state of exhaustion. I actually like recorded part of this, the first part of this episode I recorded yesterday. And then, oh, what is this? And then after I recorded that, I was really tired. So I took a nap and woke up. And after I'd woken up, I was even more tired and was just not in the mood to record anything else. So hence why I am recording the rest of this episode today. But yeah, other than that, how do I want to do this? I think we're going to have to shave off a layer of this. Let's see, how do I don't know how I want to do this. I don't know. This is going to be a really big house. This is going to be more of a castle than a house, but you know what? That's fine. It'll look cool, I think. Maybe either that or it's going to look really freaking ugly because I'm just kind of building a random shape and then I'm going to build up some walls and see how things go. Well, at the very least, I think I can say that I have an interesting shape for this house. Yeah, I don't think it's a good shape. Looking at this, I'm just like, what the heck am I building? But you know what? I just kind of made a bunch of lines and wondered how they would turn out. And this is what I got. So I guess I'll be building this. Whatever this is going to be is an entirely different question that I don't have an answer to because it is an interesting shape. A very, very interesting shape. How the heck is this going to... What is this going to turn into? I have no clue. But what I do know is that I need to shave off a layer of dirt and stuff. And you guys might be thinking, dang it, Silent Mist, you said that you weren't going to flatten stuff out anymore. I thought you were better than that. And to that I say, really? Did I ever say that? It's probably... I probably did at some point, and then I realized that I'm not a good enough of a builder to build with the curves of the land, so I'm just going to flatten everything and work with it from there. Yeah, flaws... I guess this is the main flaw with being a pretty meh builder. I wouldn't say that I am a horrifically bad builder because I am better than building a dirt hut, although I would not put it past me to build a dirt hut. It's just this very moment I am not making a dirt hut. But yeah, I'm making this, whatever this is, this shape without any guides. I'm just kind of YOLO swagging this as I go. So hopefully we'll at least get something that looks interesting and not terrible, but it might just look terrible in the end, and if that's the case, then so be it. I'll just accept my fate as a bad builder and stuff. Yeah. But, yeah, I'm gonna fill this. I'm tearing off a layer so I can fill it with, so I can put a wood floor in, and then, I'll figure out how to shape the rest of the house, but I guess there's no point in cutting it out because this is vanilla Minecraft. That's the entire point of vanilla, is to just do stuff. So what would the point of the series be if I cut out all the stuff that I was doing? But wow, I am really tired. I had a second cup of coffee not too long ago. Right now it's about 12 o'clock, so I usually get really tired about 6 to 8 hours after I wake up. And why did I fill that in if I was going to tear it out? Oh, yeah, because there was water. I usually get pretty tired around this time, and that being around 6 to 8 hours after I wake up. And, yeah, it's that time right now, so hopefully it'll pass, and hopefully I won't be super tired for long, but I might take a quick little nap. I've been trying to take, like, 20-minute power naps where applicable, where they don't really ruin my sleep schedule, but they really do help out in terms of feeling awake. Yeah, 20-minute naps are the best, and actually I've adjusted the 20-minute nap to the optimal amount of time for me, which is about 25 to 27 minutes, and I love naps. Like, wow, ever since I got into college, I have started to love naps more and more. They are just so darn nice. I just wish they didn't take so much time. That's like the worst part about them, is the amount of time that they take. But other than the fact that they are a huge time guzzler, they are quite refreshing, especially when you don't get enough sleep, such as when you're someone such as myself, which is something that I only have myself to blame, because yeah, getting enough sleep honestly isn't super difficult. It's kind of hard sometimes, but you just need the discipline to do it, and I guess that's what I'm lacking, is the discipline to be on a good sleep schedule. But alas, it is that time in my life where I can sort of do this. It's not the best for me, but in the future I probably won't be able to do it at all, have this crazy sleep schedule. So I guess I am using my my body to its fullest. And oh wow, this area right here needs to be brought down 2 layers. And then I will be able to do all the things. But I have been soaring in levels. Like, wow, I've been just going super fast. You should have seen me when I was just starting. I was going up a level every couple of seconds. And now here we are going up a level every couple, well, every like 10 seconds whenever I break stuff fast. But if you just look at my chat log, yeah, it's just nothing but level progressions. How many levels? We started off at level 68, now we're at level 93. We've gone up almost 30 levels. Wow, well, closer to 25, but still, that's a lot of levels to just soar up really quickly. But let's see, this entire area is slowly coming together. Just gotta fill in these holes that I tore out that I didn't mean to tear out. And then, let's see, this entire area could actually be raised up one more block. So this is where the foundation will begin. And what? Wait, no. How the heck? Oh, wow, this entire area is built interestingly. Well, we'll see how this thing turns out. Hopefully it won't be the worst thing that you've ever seen. Hopefully it'll be almost palatable. Okay, we need to get ourselves a bunch of dirt. Or not dirt. We need to get the wood part of this house now for the floor. And it's turning night. I think I can sleep. I don't think anyone else is on the server. Right? Oh, what? What? I don't have access to that command. Interesting. But I've confirmed my suspicions. There is no one else on the server because I was able to sleep without issue. And let's just grab all of this wood and lay it down. Wow, we are making some pretty good progress. But on the list of things that I've been doing related to making videos and whatnot, I've been slowly, well, actually not slowly, I've been power leveling in Pokemon Leaf Green because, that series is super close to being done. I think there are probably one or two episodes left in the entire series before I call it done until I decide to catch all the Pokemon in the Pokedex. But one of the problems that I was having was, well, I was losing the recordings. I am on like take 3 of finishing the Elite Four, and that's because the first time, I don't remember what happened the first time. I just remembered something happened and I lost the footage. Second time, was I recorded it, and then for some reason the last two episodes just were missing like 10 minutes each, and so I couldn't use that footage and I had to re-record it. The third time I accidentally chucked the footage because I hadn't, I chucked half of the footage, and it was like the first two episodes, so I decided, okay, I'm just gonna redo this entire chunk one more time because darn it, I want this to be done. And it's not done yet. Oh, yeah, that was like the worst when I realized that I'd thrown it away and it was too late because I had already gotten rid of the footage. But because of that, though, I've been spending a lot of time in the series, like getting stuff ready to finish up the series. And by that, I mean, like, I've been spending a lot of time leveling up my team to a point in which they are competent once again, because I've been like going, oh, what am I doing? I was going into the Elite Four with a team that was significantly weaker than the entirety of the Elite Four, like not even like kind of sort of weaker. They were a good 20 levels below the Elite Four going back the second time. And I was having some insane difficulty actually beating the Elite Four. And in these one playthrough that I had beaten them, it was very much a fluke. I won due to a really cheesy strategy that I had because there was no way that I could have won otherwise. So, because of that, I don't think that's going to happen again. I don't think I'm going to be able to win doing the same things that I did last time. So, I figure I should probably level up my team a little bit to make it doable and not the most frustrating thing in the entire world. So I've been like power leveling like crazy on that level, in that game. And I've raised my entire team up by about 10 levels. So that is going to make recording the last couple of episodes much more pleasant instead of this frustration. But yeah, I do think that I'll record that sometime soon. Probably not today because I'm so ridiculously tired. I didn't realize how tired I was until I started recording, and now I'm really starting to feel it. So after I'm done recording this episode, I will probably take myself a nice nap and then return to do some more stuff because, let's see, TerraFirmaCraft, I have some stuff that I need to do in that game, and then what else? I kind of want to do stuff on the Feed the Beast server, but at the same time, do I really? Maybe. There's so many things that I want to do, and then I've like just had this knack to do stuff. And the worst thing that happens from that is when I really want to do something, but I can't think of what I want to do. Like, over the last few days, I've wanted to be super productive with recording, but I couldn't think of something to record. So I've been doing a lot of TerraFirmaCraft stuff, which is good. And then there's obviously this. I've been streaming every once in a while. Been playing a lot of Overwatch when I stream. And yeah, Overwatch is a really fun game to stream. I'm going to be doing that for quite some time, probably. Heck, I could stream that, but it's not really... I thought I just heard someone come in, and I was like, oh god, who's that? But, what was I saying? Oh yeah, Overwatch isn't really something that's recordable. It's something that's very much streamable, but I can't imagine it being something that would be too fun for me to make episodes out of, unless I made highlights, which those would be pretty nice to have. Highlight reels are always a lot of fun. But those are really difficult to make. They take a lot of time. You have to spend a lot of time playing a bunch of games just to get the good moments, which then you can edit those into some comprehensive highlight reel. And that's something that would just take a lot of time. And actually, I've been like, whenever I play, I have Shadowplay open in the background. So I just capture everything and take 30-second highlights whenever something cool happens. And I have a decent collection of those. I just haven't gotten around to editing them because... Well, actually, not for any reason. I just haven't edited them. I don't think I have enough to really make a good highlight reel. And my really good plays are, like, generally okay plays in the grand scheme of things. So getting enough, like, the really good ones are few and far between. Like, I'll record a bunch of them and they'll be pretty cool. But then there'll be the really good ones, which really don't happen too often. So I don't have enough of the amazing clips to really highlight my Overwatch skills. Not that I'm a particularly fantastic player, I'm just decent enough to slowly rank up, even though the ranking system is, in my opinion, extremely broken right now. But yeah, other than that, I'll break that. I don't know. I've been thinking of starting up Stardew Valley again, because that would probably be something that I could record a lot of relatively quickly. And just have a lot of content just go up on a regular basis. And I make it sound like I want to just record stuff so I don't have to record stuff later on, but it's really satisfying. This is something I've always felt as a content creator, and that is whenever you have a surplus of videos, it's just a really, really satisfying feeling being able to schedule a bunch of things ahead of time and not have to worry about having a video up for like a long time. The best example of this was last summer when I was going crazy recording stuff, recording Leaf Green, as a matter of fact. And funny thing, it's taken me over a year to do this series, even though I've been at the point of almost being done for the longest time. But when I was like 50 episodes ahead in recording, it was just super satisfying seeing all of those videos scheduled and ready to go, and then rendering them all out. Well, before that, rendering them all out was very satisfying, just going through all of them and knocking through progress like there was no tomorrow. It's just a very satisfying feeling having this surplus of videos, knowing that there isn't going to be a time where you're not going to have content going up. And that's something that I haven't experienced ever since last summer. And I've been slowly working on doing that with TerraFirmaCraft. I've had, well, it's nowhere near the level of Leaf Green, but right now with TerraFirmaCraft, I am 2 or 3 episodes ahead of what I'm posting. Yeah, like I'll record a couple episodes at a time and then post them every day. So I have a buffer of, I think right now I have 2 or 3 videos that are currently in the buffer. So there's that. Stardew Valley would be easy to do a lot of because at least with my playthrough of Stardew Valley, I'm not really skipping out on much. So I just have to like record a couple of days worth of game, and then there you go. You have a couple days worth of video. And the only problem with that is that, I haven't played Stardew Valley outside of recording. So I'm not too familiar with the game itself. So when I'm playing the game, I'm basically learning everything as I play it. And that can sort of cause a little bit of stagnation with the series because I don't have, I don't know what I'm doing and I have to figure it out while I'm playing. And sometimes I have to make a bunch of cuts because I don't know what I should be doing. I need to figure out if I can do something else. And it's just... It's an interesting experience, but nonetheless, it's an experience that I have been enjoying. However, I've sort of wished that I I streamed the game instead of Let's Play the game because I've wanted to play it a lot more than I've been recording it. And as a result, there have just been like a lot of times where I haven't played the game because I planned on recording it. And yeah, it's weird. It's like a catch-22. You want to play the game, but you want to record it when you play the game, but you don't want to record right now, so you can't play the game. And therefore, you don't play the game. And it's just like, oh, this is not what I wanted to do. This is not what I wanted to have happen. And then it didn't. Wow, this is really weird looking because it's not a smooth line. Let's see. Yeah, this is interesting, to say the very least, what I am currently building. All of you guys that are like decent builders are probably looking at this and wondering, what the heck are you building, Drew? But to you, I say, I have no clue what I'm building. I'm just kind of putting blocks together and seeing what happens. Yeah. But yeah, this is the foundation for our house. It's going to be a really big house, apparently. I wasn't planning on it being this gigantic, but I guess it is. But I think I'm going to end things off here. We've been going for quite some time now. Yeah, we've been going for, I don't know, about 20 minutes or so. So I'm going to end things off here. I'm going to go take a nap because I am really freaking tired. And I will see you all again in the next part. Hopefully it won't be too far off because, yeah, now that I have a goal in this series, that's like the biggest problem with every series. I don't have a goal. Right now my goal is to build a really big house. So since that is the current goal, I have something to work towards, which means I have something to record, which means this series won't go another month without seeing the next episode. So guys, I do hope that you enjoyed today's video. If you did, please do leave a like. It always helps out a ton. And I will see you all again in the next episode. Until then, farewell. Wow, it's been a long time since I've ended off the vlog that way. The series that way. Or any video that way. I've been saying bye-bye, but today I said farewell. Isn't that like a song? I don't know. I'll see you guys in the next episode.